What's up, y'all? It's Friday, right at noon on a Friday, so you know what that means. Starting out the ammo hunting week again. If y'all aren't familiar with my ammo videos I post every week, I go from Friday to Thursday, so I start the week on a Friday and then roll them all in every day that week into the Thursday video, just so I don't have a channel full of nothing but ammo hunting videos. I just do one of them a week. Last week was pretty good. Actually, we found some pretty good stuff, pretty decent deals on a few things, so maybe this week will be just as good, if not better. So we're gonna run in here to the Rural King first and see what's going on in there today, and I'll let y'all have a look. All right, y'all, a couple new things in here. Actually, look at this. They got 6.5 Creedmoor, 125 grain, $24.99. 17 HMR here, 17 grain VMAX stuff, $13.49. They got some of this ammo black line. I don't know if that's upgraded from the regular or not, $21.99. So more, we'll probably get a box just to try out. Got more of this Aguila M855-556, $180 for 300 rounds, so definitely too high on that. Got the Winchester 855s. These are $120 for 200 rounds, so a little bit better, but still nothing great. 20 round boxes of the green tips here, the X-Tax, those are $13.50. 20 round boxes of the 193s here, 5.56, same thing, $13.50 on those also. Other than that, about the same stuff in here, just more of it. All right, y'all, they literally had just got a shipment of ammo in there, was in the process of putting it on the shelf when I came in there. As y'all see, they got a few new things. I just ran through quick what the new stuff was. The 17 HMR, hadn't seen in Rural King in a while. The 6.5 Creedmoor is always good to find some of that in there, and that was a decent price on it. A bunch of M855 green tip 556 rounds and a couple other new things in there. So just a few new things we got. We did get a little bit of stuff in there while we were there, but other than that, about the same stuff as what they've had. A lot more of the same nine and stuff that they got in there too. On the way home, I gotta run in here into Walmart, so we're gonna take a look in there and see what kind of ammo they got in there while we had it. All right, y'all, we had to come into Walmart. We got a few things. They got a bunch of 12 gauge in here as usual. Looks like they got a bunch of Target. I'm not sure what them white boxes right there are. I think that's 20 gauge, but tons of 12 gauge. Looks like they got some 222 Remington down there. Bunch of 20 gauge, a box of 30-06. I'm gonna grab if I can find somebody. Some 350 Legend. Bunch of 7.62x51. Like I say, we got them 22 anniversary boxes overpriced, but tons of 12 gauge in here. All right, y'all, made it out to Wally World. Man, they had a bunch of 12 gauge and stuff in there. A lot of 12 gauge, good bit of 20 gauge in there. Had them crazy anniversary boxes of 22, as y'all saw. And then they had that lonely little box of 30-06, which we finally did get somebody to go over there and grab for us. So we picked that up. So it was worth stopping in there to grab that anyway. But anyway, we're gonna call it there for today. We're gonna head back to the house and we'll come out here another day. Morning, y'all. It's Tuesday morning, Thanksgiving week, about 10 o'clock Tuesday morning. We're gonna head up to the Rural King and see what's going on. Hadn't been up there at all this weekend, so be interested to see if they got anything going on in there. This may be the last day that I go out this week. I still won't post anything till Thursday on Thanksgiving, but may go out tomorrow on Wednesday, I'm not sure, but this might be the last day I go out. So if it is, y'all, obviously y'all know, y'all see the wrap up at the end. But let's run up in here to the Rural King and see if they got anything going on in there today. All right, y'all, looks like about the same stuff in here for right now. They got tons of these buckets of bullets. 116.92 again. Got a little bit of 380 in here too, not a whole lot. Got one case, just regular 380 FMJ for $23.99, so we definitely gonna get a few of those. PMC 556 for $12.99. They got a bunch of monolithic Norma 380s, bunch of 300 blackout steel, 219, 1299, 556, 193s here. Still got a handful of those 380 centrifires left for $12.99, but other than that, about the same stuff. All right, y'all, made it out to Rural King again. They had a few new things in there, not a whole lot to talk about, but the 380, the white box Winchester, they just put that out right before I got there, so I grabbed a few boxes of that. The rest of it's about the same. If y'all noticed, they didn't have the Aguila 250 round box out. They made them put those back up again until tomorrow, until Wednesday, so I don't know. I think somebody was confused of whether it's supposed to be out or not supposed to be out, but anyway. We may go back by there tomorrow. Like I say, this might be the last one you see until Thursday, but we might go back by there tomorrow just to see what's going on. But anyway, let's run into Dunham's and see what's going on in there this week. All right, quick run through in the Dunham's here. Looks like they got some V-Crown 9s, $21.99 I think it is. Yeah, $22. About the same 9 they've had in here forever. I think these are 9s here. Yeah, 20 HSTs for $37. $22 for the V-Crown. Steelcase Red Army Standard 9 for $25. Federal, $24. 38 Special, $37. Got some 45 ACP, $35. As far as the rifle stuff, it's about the same rifle stuff too. Don't look like they got much new in since last time we was in here. Plenty of 223, 556, but of course it's $18 for a box of 20. As far as anything different, there's a little bit of 22 250. I hadn't seen that in here. $33 for 22 250. Here's some 270. Ain't seen that in a while. $35 for the 270. 300 blackout, 150 grainers here. $35. Deer season XP. I don't think I've ever even seen that, to be honest with you. Again, plenty of 308 like y'all seen in here. They got tons of different 308. So some 30 carbine. Other than that, it looks like the new stuff is that Winchester 300 blackout, the 270, and the 22 250. All those are new. All right, y'all, pretty much the same old song and dance in Dunham's. They had a few new things in there, like that 22 250 and that 270. I can't believe that was even in there. Although, as y'all see, they didn't have but one box of each, and the price was out of sight on that stuff. There's probably some hunters who would probably grab that stuff up even at that price, but I don't need it. Other than that, plenty of ammo in there, but plenty of high prices too. I mean, that stuff is just so high. Y'all saw the prices in there. We're gonna call it for today, and this may be the last trip out here this week because of Thanksgiving and all that stuff going on, because I'll be honest, I don't come out on Black Friday, period. There ain't no deal good enough for me to come out for at all, nowhere, no how. So this may be the last stop. I may run to Rural King tomorrow morning, but I'm not sure. Y'all know either way. If you see me back at the house after this, you know this is the last day. If not, you'll see me in the morning headed to the Rural King. Morning, y'all. It's Wednesday morning, so obviously I decided to come back out one more time this week. I'm gonna run up here to the Rural King. They're supposed to put them Aguila 22s back out. Somebody told me they was gonna be even cheaper today, but I haven't heard anything about that. But either way, I'm gonna grab a few more boxes of it. It's not even quite 9 o'clock. I figured I'd get out here real early. I'm just not one for fighting these crowds even to save a few bucks, I'll be honest with you. So get out here early and see if they got anything new, and if not, we'll pick up a couple of them boxes of Aguila 22 and get back to the house. All right, y'all, they was right, $13.99 on the Aguila 22, so that's a heck of a deal right now for sure, so we're gonna get some of that. Other than that, just a quick scan, looks like the same exact stuff. Well, I got these PMC Bronze 223s for $12.99. Then they got a bunch of Steelcase 223 for $8.99. But other than that, it looks like about the same in here. But we definitely gonna get some of them Aguilas. All right, y'all, made it out to Rural King. Whoever told me that about the $13.99 Aguila was exactly right. They're on for $13.99 right now. So I got 2,000 rounds of that stuff in there just then. I paid $16.97 or whatever the other day, but they hooked me up with a little bit of discount on some other stuff to make up for it. So we came out good in the end. Somebody told me that my local shop had some primers in there right now, so we're gonna swing by there and see what's going on in there, and then we're gonna head to the house. I do got a little bit of primers in here. $5.99 for the small rifle Federal. Got these number 41 CCIs. Those are $8.99 for some reason. Pretty much the same. Y'all know a little bit harder on those. Got a couple of eight pound powders, HS6 and IMR 4227. $249 for the HS6, $299 for the 4227. All right, y'all, made it out the local shop. As y'all can see in there, they did have a few primers in there. They had some small rifle, Federal, and CCI, and they actually had a couple pounds or a couple jugs, 8 pound jugs of powder in there too. I didn't get any of the powder, but I did pick up some of the primers for sure. So pretty decent stuff in there right now. So let's head back to the house. I'll show y'all what we got this week. All right, y'all, we back at the house on Thanksgiving Thursday. First off, hope all of y'all have had and are having a very happy Thanksgiving, spending time with your family or whatever else you're planning on doing on Thanksgiving. I hope y'all having a great one. Got some pretty good stuff this week, so I'm gonna start it right out with Rural King. So the Black Friday deal's going on. So y'all know they had that Aguila, the 250-round boxes that I've been buying for $16.99, which was a decent price right now. Well, for Black Friday, where they started yesterday on Wednesday, they marked it down to $13.99. So I went in there and got 8 boxes of it. So we got 8 boxes of Aguila for $13.99. Y'all seen 6 boxes I bought. Well, I bought another 2 boxes earlier in this week. I think it was Monday, maybe it been Monday, Tuesday, I forget which day. But I bought 2 more boxes of it at the $16.99. So I went in there and these were $13.99. I'm like, man, what the heck, you know. But the guys looked out for me in there. One of the managers in there, I was talking to him about it. He said, well, don't worry about it. I'll make it up to you on something else. So he gave me a discount on some other stuff to made up for the $24. So he looked out for me, so I greatly appreciate that. Those guys are awesome up there. So made up the difference and then got 2,000 more rounds for $13.99 a box. So jump on that deal for sure. That's a good deal right now because that's some good ammo, actually, the 40 grain solid. So 2,000 rounds of the Aguila. And then one of the other days, I forget what it was, maybe Friday, y'all saw I went in there and they had some pretty hard to find stuff right now. Some good old 6.5 Creedmoor. This stuff is pretty hard to find right now, and when you do, it's a crazy price that most places are asking for it. So I went in there, they had the Winchester Deer Season XP, the 125 grainers, Extreme Point, 6.5 Creedmoor, as y'all can see. And these were $24.97 a box. So I got 3 boxes of those. So 3 boxes of 6.5 Creedmoor at $24.97 per box. Now, one of the other days I went in there and got some of this crazy Black Line ammo. I ain't Black Line ammo. This stuff wasn't a great deal by any means. This stuff was $21.99 for 20, which I mean is not terrible for defensive ammo, but you can get the regular ammo ink hollow points for $17.99. So these are supposed to be some premium, I guess, ammo ink hollow points, hyper clean technology, coated with some kind of black coating on them. But as you can see, Just your hollow points, like I say, it's got some type of black coating on it. So I figured these would be good. The only reason I actually bought these were for some testing. So I'll do these Black Lines against the standard ammo ink 115 grainers, and we'll see what you're getting for the extra money you're paying, if anything. So got 2 boxes of those. And then that same day, I went ahead and got some of these Centerfire 380s since they still had some in there. You know, I've got these in 9 and a handful of them in 45, and I think I've got them in 40 Smith & Wesson even. I think they're supposed to be frangible, so it'll be interesting to see what these do in the jail. So picked up 2 boxes of these because they were cheap enough. They were only $12.99 a box for 20 rounds each, 75 grainers. So got 2 boxes of those in 380. And then one of those same days, we had a nice little surprise find in the Walmart. Well, they had right much ammo in there, a bunch of 12 gauge and stuff in there. To be honest with you, I've got so much 12 gauge right now, I wasn't really interested in any of that. But they did have 1 box of 30-06 y'all saw in there. Just regular old Federal PowerShock 30-06, 150 grainer. Just good old 30-06, the big boy there. So we definitely had to grab that because this is pretty rare to find right now also. And if you do, again, it's a high price on it. And this was $23.96 at Wally World. So $23.96 for the box of 30-06. So we got 1 of those. And then Tuesday, I think it was, like I say, I get my days all mixed up. Went in there and they had literally just rolled a pallet in of some stuff. Most of it was the same stuff they had, as y'all saw. But they got some 380 in there, some good old Winchester 380. Just regular 95 grain full metal jacket 380. So I had to get a few boxes of those. These were $23.99, so about the lowest you're gonna find 380 brass right now, to be honest. So 3 boxes of 380 at $23.99. Then my local shop, went in there, they had a few things in there. I didn't do a whole lot of filming in there because usually I just go in there to see if there's any super deals or any primers or powder, and they had quite a few small rifle primers in there, as y'all saw. They had these Federals for $5.99 for 100, and then they had the CCIs for $8.99 a 100, which they're basically the same thing. I believe the CCIs, those white box military style, they want to call them, I think those are supposed to be a little bit of harder primer, not as soft, but they all work just as good if you ask me. So got some Federal small rifle primers. I went ahead and picked 500 of those up since they were in there and they were $5.99. Y'all saw they also had a couple of 8-pound jugs of powder in there, but I didn't really need that much of those two types of
powder for enough to get 8 pounds of it. So just got some primers in there. I've got right many primers, as y'all know, but $5.99, I went ahead and picked up 500 more of them. That was the pickups for the week that I bought locally. Now I had a few things sent to me again this week. So starting off, got some guard dogs, some 45 ACP Federal Premium guard dogs. These were sent to me by Tom. Base Logic is his YouTube username. These are some pretty cool rounds. I've actually got some projectiles of these that were sent to me by Uphold the Second in 9mm that I haven't loaded yet, but Tom had some of these in 45 ACP. These are actually encapsulated hollow points. I know they look solid, but they're actually encapsulated hollow points, and they've got a polymer insert in them. I don't know how well you can see in that picture. They've got a polymer insert. I believe the purpose of these are that they're supposed to expand even when they hit hard barriers first. So basically to prevent over penetration if you're defending yourself inside your home and you hit a wall or whatever the case may be. It's supposed to go ahead and expand even on hard barriers, so keep from over penetrating. So he sent us a box of those to test. That should be really interesting stuff right there for sure. So Tom, I greatly appreciate that, brother. Thank you very much for sending those. So got one box of those. And then Mark sent me a bunch of brass. I'll show you just a few of them. Sent me some all kind of different brass. 243, 300 WinMag, some 38 Special. I've got some 22, 250 he sent me. Some 44 Mag. He's got a box full of bunch of different bags of brass. So I'm definitely going to get to cleaning it up right now. Brass is expensive, man. I mean, brass is super expensive. So I greatly appreciate him sending this to me. So Mark, thank you very much for this brass. Like I say, I'm going to get on cleaning that stuff up and see if we can load some of it up. And then last but not least, Triple H Services sent me a cool little box full of stuff. He had sent me some stuff before, y'all seen on the channel. He sent me some ammo and some a bunch of different, he's actually sent me some different mugs before and a lot of different stuff. Well, this time he sent me 10 of these tumblers here. And if y'all can see, they got the Tools and Target logo on them. So that was pretty doggone awesome. Triple H, I really appreciate it, brother. I appreciate all y'all who sends me stuff like this. Thoughtful stuff, some useful stuff, stuff for testing. It's really awesome that y'all send stuff like this. So he actually, like I say, sent me 10 of these brand new tumblers like this with the Tools and Target logo. So that's very, very cool. I really, really appreciate that. But that was it, y'all. A little Black Friday deal on the 22LR. They've still got all the tools at 10%. Off, so if you're looking for something specific, now might be the time to jump on it and save you a little money. I'm sure there's a lot more Black Friday deals out there, but I'll be honest with y'all, I'm the kind of guy who would rather pay $5 more than to go out on Black Friday. I am not into fighting those crowds to save five, even 10 bucks, to be honest with you. 10 bucks is a lot right now, but my sanity's worth a whole lot more than that. I mean, I just do not go out on Black Friday. I just don't do it. But let me know what's going on y'all's next of the woods. If y'all got any Black Friday deals going on in y'all's area, if y'all taking advantage of some of them already, let me know down in the comments what's going on. If you enjoy the video, as always, make sure you hit that thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. I've got a bunch of stuff already filmed, a whole batch of it with some weird mic problems in a lot of it, but I've got a new camera going on and a new mic system I'm going to be using probably on this, not this coming week's worth of videos, but probably the following week. It should be a whole lot better audio and video quality out there. So I'm trying to up my game for y'all, since y'all supporting the channel as much as y'all doing. But again, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell notification icon down below so you can check stuff out as soon as I upload it. Check out my Amazon storefront affiliate link down in the description like I always ask y'all. If you do your shopping through Amazon anyway, hit that link first and it takes you right through the regular Amazon site like normal. Doesn't cost you anything extra at all. And anything you buy through Amazon after going through that link, we get a kickback from Amazon towards the channel. So I greatly appreciate that. A lot of shopping time coming up right now, so y'all hit that link up, help me out. I appreciate that. Appreciate all my Range Gang members who reached out and hit that join button. That really, really helps the channel there. Appreciate each and every one of y'all, like I always tell you, who watches my videos, thumbs up, subscribes, and leave me comments down below. That really, really helps. Let me know again what's going on in y'all's neck of the woods. If you're seeing some decent deals right now, if the ammo availability is getting any better, let me know what's going on. Plenty of stuff coming down the line, so stay tuned for that. Have a great Thanksgiving, and in the meantime, stay safe, stay prepared, and I'll see y'all soon.